I've got the capacitors, so I'll be attempting to put them or put it in today. But before I start, I have a disclaimer. For those of you who would like to put parts into your inverter, just remember that this is a high voltage inverter. If you don't know what you're doing, or if you're in doubts, or if you're not comfortable, please get a licensed technician. I'm not a technician, I'm a do-it-yourself guy. With all that said, this have been off for some time, so it's discharged already. In this video, I would be placing the capacitor and taking out the thermostat. What I notice with this inverter, the thermostat is too far, because up here is what getting hot, down here like the heat is traveling down. Now the damage is already done. Time the heat reach down here, the damage is already done. So I'll be placing the capacitor and I'll test that for y'all to see that the fan is working, which I've tried it already. With all that said, let's begin. Excuse me. Okay, I'll pause the video. I didn't put on the iron. I won't pause the video. Yeah, this is the final part. I've put part of the casing on. I took out this thermostat and put two wires because this portion of the board is what getting hot before down here. Let me put on the fan so y'all can see. I didn't bother to change the thermostat because it's good. I'll use the same thermostat it has. I'm using my benchtop power supply. And it's on. The fan is down here. Now if I connect these two, you hear the fan is on. So what I'm going to do is put the thermostat somewhere down here. I've put some shields between the capacitors and the fuse. Let me switch off. Yeah, I drain the power. This is the final. I've completed it. Tomorrow, if God spare, I'll be installing it, putting the top cover back, and installing it. Let me go through what I've done. I've changed the capacitor. I think it's this side. I took out the thermostat for the fan right here. I put these two wires. I put the thermostat here because this part of the inverter is getting very, very hot, and down here is mild. You could touch here, keep your hand down here, but here you cannot, because it's getting very, very hot. So I put the thermostat up here. The thermostat is 45°C. So as soon as it gets hot, it would put on the fan. I put these protect the capacitors. I put on each of them to protect the capacitors, because apart from the fan not coming on, the speed connectors for the fuse were resting on the capacitors, and I assume that's what blew the capacitors. So I've done all that. Let me put a little power to it. This is it. I won't put the soldering iron on the thermostat to put on the fan. This is it for this video. If you find it was informative, And if you find it was any help to any one of you who do have one of these inverters, I hope you learn something from this video. Until the next one, thank you for watching and goodbye.